Woo! Let's get it. Yo, 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 what is good, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. Thank you guys so much for stopping by once again. Today, I want to switch it up a little bit, give you guys a little bit of an informational video. I want to give you guys some tips, some tricks on how to cop this box logo on Friday. I guess you guys can, you know, use this video for more than just copping box logos. You can probably use this for copying anything on the Supreme website. I am going to also make a video for you Bada boys out there. This is just strictly for the Manu boys. I know I get a lot of heat for, you know, using a lot of bots, but to be honest, I do rely on Manu a good amount as well. So I want to give you some tips and tricks that work for me. Hopefully you guys can adapt these tips as well and hopefully cook up as well. But before I get into the actual video, I do want to mention one quick thing. If you guys are not already aware, I've been mentioning it for the past couple videos. I am doing a giveaway. When I hit 5,000 subscribers, I wanted to announce a giveaway. I'm giving away 8 packs of Oreos to 4 lucky winners. Each winner will take home 2 packs of Oreos. Again, like I've been saying, you don't have to pay a dime out of your pocket. I'm going to be covering shipping fee for you guys as well, so it's literally free Oreos. Once again, I would definitely not recommend sleeping on this. This is definitely your chance to get some packs, but it's very, very, very easy to enter. All you have to do is 1, hit that subscribe button down below. 2, go follow my personal Instagram at ugly.img. 3, go follow my cook group's Instagram at ugly.group. And of course, lastly, drop your Instagram handle down below in the comment section so that I can verify that you follow both accounts. But once again, do not sleep on it. I'm probably going to announce it tomorrow. If I don't do a live cop tomorrow, I might do it on Friday, because as you guys know, there's you know, a couple of big releases coming. If I don't announce it tomorrow, I promise that I will announce it on Friday during the live cop. But again, good luck to you guys and enter up ASAP. But enough of that, let's get into the actual video. I want to mention real quick, I probably won't get to everything in this video. There are some important things that you obviously should know about when it comes to Supreme and copping Supreme manually. But if I do miss out on anything, please, please, please just drop it down in the comment section below. I always like to, you know, expand my game when it comes to copping manually. I'm definitely not the greatest, I will definitely admit that. But if you guys do have any tips that you know, work for you, I would definitely like for you guys to drop it down below. But let's get into it. The first thing that you guys obviously need is an autofill. I personally go always with Chrome autofill. There's a lot of extensions and there's a lot of apps that work as well. For example, Filler. There's also the Lightning Bolt autofill. There's a ton of different autofill extensions. I like to keep it basic. I like to use the Chrome autofill. It works for me pretty smoothly. And to be honest, I never have a problem with it. There were some times last season where I would use the Filler extension or the Lightning Bolt extension to cop, and to be honest, sometimes it just felt very laggy, or sometimes Supreme just as a whole would just ban the use of that extension. So I just said screw it, I'm just going to stick with Chrome autofill. For you mobile guys out there, if you guys don't have access to a computer and you want to go mobile, Filler is a lot better on mobile than it is on you know, on desktop. So if you guys don't have an autofill on mobile, that is definitely a great one to use. I would always recommend, if on mobile, the Safari autofill settings, because I know it doesn't autofill the entire form at once, but as you click through the different fields that is necessary to you know, fill out, it'll just give you the information there. So in a way, it's not as fast, but it's definitely a little bit more reliable in my opinion. But as far as some other things that I would recommend, a lot of people always you know, put this to the side, and me included, sometimes I forget to do this, is have your payment information copied and ready to be pasted. I cannot tell you guys how many times I've taken an L simply because I had to go ahead and type in my my credit card information manually. One, obviously it's a hassle to type in all those numbers, and if you don't know your numbers by heart, you're gonna have to go get your wallet, get the card out, and fill out the information after that. By that time, it's usually an L. So I would definitely recommend, if you don't have the credit card information, you know, pasted, at least have it in front of you ready to go, or at least write it down on a piece of paper so you already know, you know, I guess you have a little quicker access to it. But again, I definitely cannot stress how important that is, so please do not sleep on that. But as far as some other things, there is a little trick that you can use on Supreme. Again, this is not going to work for your payment information. This is only going to work for your address. So you're still going to have your payment information copied and ready to go. But this works perfectly fine. if you guys have not purchased on the website before, if this is your first time, actually you guys can, you know, follow me while I talk about it. You guys can go to the Supreme website, add anything to cart. After that, you go to checkout and you fill out your information. At the bottom of the checkout form, there should be a little checkbox that says remember my information. Go to the payment side and just enter any random, you know, credit card number. Obviously do not use your own, because I don't want you guys to check out something that you don't want to buy. Just input any random number, any random expiration date, and any random security code. Hit checkout. It's obviously going to get declined, but after you attempt to check out, after that point, it's always going to save your information, at least until you clear your browser history or your browser cookies. That is a great way to have your information just autofilled automatically. You don't even have to press a button. You don't have to, you know, rely on any autofill. Sometimes they will clear it, so you have to make sure, like 30 minutes before the drop, by adding something to cart and hitting checking out, just make sure that your information is already filled out, because obviously I would hate for you guys to you know, have the box logo in cart and trying to check out and your information is not filled out at all. It works for me, it's great. Again, this is not going to work for your payment information, so as I said before, you're still going to have your payment information copied and ready to go. But in my opinion, that is probably the fastest way to check out manually. I would definitely recommend you guys adapt that as well. As far as some other tips that I can give you guys, know about the category that your item is going to drop in. This not only applies to box logos. A lot of people like to navigate from the Supreme homepage. That is definitely not the way to go. Anytime that there's a hype drop, I would recommend starting in the category that that item is going to drop in. If you don't know the category that it's going to drop in, I would definitely refer to your cook group. Your cook group probably would know, or somebody in your group would know. I try for every release to give my group a layout of the page where it's going to drop, as well as the category and the colors that it's going to drop in as well. But obviously for an item like a box logo, for example, like we're going to get this Friday, it's obviously going to be in the t-shirts category. So by loading into the t-shirts category before the drop and just refreshing that page, of course there can be some lag, there's going to be a lot of glitches, but being there is going to give you guys a little bit of an advantage over somebody who's starting on the homepage. Again, this applies for more than just box logos. This applies for most of the hype releases. If it's a hype hat, you want to be in the hats category. If it's a hype jacket, you want to be in the jackets category, obviously. Again, I don't know why this seems like a kind of a no-brainer, but for some reason, a lot of people just like to start on the homepage. And yeah, that is definitely not the way to go if you ask me. But as far as some other things, I would say do not hesitate. If you want a size large and by mistake you cop a size medium, just stick with it, because the odds of you being able to remove that and add in the large is extremely unlikely. At the end of the day, it's still a box logo. If you actually do want a large and you get a medium, you can probably end up cheating it pretty easily, in my opinion, or you can end up selling it and just buying the large with the money that you had and hopefully even make a little bit of money in between. But yeah, I've done that as well. It happens. And yeah, it's better to actually cop than to miss out, if you ask me. But some other things, let me think. This is not really even a tip, it's more so like advice. At the end of the checkout process, if you actually do get in a cart and you manage to check out and it processes and you get that dreaded decline screen, do not close that screen. Sometimes it happens that, you know, the website is just so overloaded that you get a decline. They're just feeding everybody declines and it eventually turns out to a successfully checked out page. That's happened to me before. In fact, I'm like infamous for, you know, getting the decline and closing the tab right away, not knowing that that screen can actually turn into a checkout. So again, if you guys get that decline button, just sit on it for a couple minutes. If it does not, obviously try to go back and catch a restock, but there definitely are times where I've seen that decline screen turn into a checkout screen. So definitely look out for that. But that is the video, guys. I hope you guys are successful in copying a box logo on Friday. I really, really, really hope that I'm successful as well. I cannot tell you guys how much I want this t-shirt. This t-shirt is fire. Probably one or two, or maybe like top three top box logo t-shirts that we've ever gotten. And I'm not saying that I'm not reaching. That t-shirt is fire. The fact that it's a Murakami box logo is just insane in my opinion. So yeah, I really, really, really wish us all the best in copying one of those. Again, this does not only apply for box logos or copying box logos, this applies for literally copying anything. So on Thursday, if for example, you're going for that varsity jacket, you can definitely apply these tips as well. But I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, please drop a like for your boy, comment your thoughts, and please subscribe to the channel. Please do not roast my hair. This quarantine got me just stressed out. Drop a like down below if you look like shit like me. I don't even care. You guys can say whatever the hell you want. But I appreciate you guys for watching. Again, go check out that giveaway. Do not sleep. Go check out my accounts. I promise you guys will not be mad if you walked away with some free Oreos. But until next time, stay tuned for those live cops. I appreciate you guys. Peace.